doubt. But if all else fails and you can't manipulate the statistics to your advantage, then like Donald Trump, you could just make it up. So this is an infographic that Donald Trump retweeted back in November 2015 when he was running for the presidential candidacy for the Republican Party. It comes from the Crime Statistics Bureau of San Francisco, and there's a spoiler alert here, the Crime Statistics Bureau of San Francisco does not exist. This infographic, when it was traced back, actually came from a far-right website with neo-Nazi sympathies, so that's how much we should trust it. But nevertheless, these are the statistics that were written down on this infographic, which Trump retweeted without doing a fact check. So it was about the ethnicities of people who were being killed in the United States and people who were killing them. So it says in particular, these are the statistics which we should focus on because they're entirely incorrect. The proportion of white people killed by black people is 81%. The proportion of white people killed by white people is just 16%. The proportion of black people killed by other black people is 97%, which is, seems alarmingly high. The other statistics which are interesting are because of the cases of police brutality in the United States, this infographic was trying to diminish the proportion of people, both black and white, who were killed by police. So it said that black people killed by police was just 1% and white people killed by police was 3%. So I did some research and actually found the real figures from the FBI and from the Guardian website. And these are the real figures. So in particular, I want to highlight to you the proportion of white people killed by black people is not 81%, it's 16%. And the proportion of white people killed by other white people is not 16%, it's 81%. These two figures have just been crudely swapped over in the infographic. Additionally, when we're talking about police brutality, the proportion of black people killed by police is actually 11%, and similarly, the proportion of white people killed by police is 16%. So this is a big issue because at the time when this was being retweeted, the Black Lives Matter movement in the United States, which was designed and formulated to highlight cases of police brutality against black people, was at its zenith. It was founded back in 2013 after Trayvon Martin, an unarmed black teenager, came back from the shops with a bag of sweets and was killed by a Hispanic community enforcement officer, despite the fact that he was unarmed. Now, the Black Lives Matter movement really ballooned in the United States. There were riots across the country, in particular in Ferguson when Michael Brown was killed. And actually by 2016, the Black Lives Matter movement had made its way across the Atlantic to the UK, and it had raised the ire of Sun journalist Rod Liddle. So on the 8th of September 2016, he wrote the following: "There's no doubt whatsoever that the greatest danger to black people in the USA is other black people. Black on black murders average more than 4,000 each year. The number of black men killed by US cops, rightly or wrongly, he says, is little more than 100 each year." And then he finishes with this, this taunt: "Go on, do the math." So I did the math. I looked at the statistics, which was the most basic piece of math you could do. And for the year 2015, which is the last year that Liddle could conceivably have got statistics for, these are from the FBI website, by the way, the total number of killings in which the victim was black was 2,664. Liddle said black on black murders average more than 4,000 each year. So clearly not true. Of those 2,664, we've already seen that 89% of them were committed by black people, which is 2,380. 229 were committed by white people. And then the other thing that Liddle said was that the number of black men killed by police officers, US cops, rightly or wrongly, he says, is little more than 100 each year. Again, I checked out the statistics and the figures are actually three times that. So 307 killings by law enforcement officers of black people over that year, 2015. Law enforcement officers here, the definition that I've gone with is people who are authorized and carry a badge and a firearm. These are the FBI statistics on that, and the police enforcement figures come from The Guardian again. To give you a comparison, for killings in which the victim was white, there were 3,167 killings in which the victim was white, 500 committed by black people, 2,574 by white people, and 584 by law enforcement officers. So Liddle is making this claim that that black people are committing proportionally far more murders than you would expect them to. But I think by focusing on the people who are doing the killing rather than on the people who are being killed, Liddle hides a really important statistic, which is this statistic here, the total number of killings of what black people and white people. Black people in the US count for roughly 12% of the population, white people count for 73% of the population, yet black people account for 45% of all the killings in the United States. And for me, that's probably the most startling statistic out of any of these statistics, is this disproportionate amount of killings of black people in comparison to white people in the United States. Nevertheless, let's move on to Liddle's other statement. There's no doubt whatsoever that the greatest danger to black people in the USA is other black people. Okay, so I want to rethink this in the light of how many black people there are in the United States and how many law enforcement officers there are in the USA. So I'm going to do a thought experiment with you, and it goes like this. In 2017, and these are real statistics, dogs killed 40 US citizens. In the same year, bears killed 2 US citizens. Who would you rather I left you alone in a room with? A dog or a bear? For me, I know the answer is a dog. The reason why dogs kill more people in the USA than bears do is not because dogs are inherently more murderous than bears or more dangerous than bears. It's because there are a hell of a lot more dogs in the United States than there are bears, and dogs encounter people more often than bears do. In exactly the same way, the reason why more black people in the United States are killed by other black people is not because black people are inherently more dangerous or murderous than police officers. It's because there are a hell of a lot more black people in the United States than there are police officers. So what we really need to do to calculate who we should be more scared of. Say if there's a black man walking down a dark alley and he comes across someone coming towards him and he's worried they might murder him, who should he prefer it to be, a black person or a police officer? So to figure that out, what we need to find out is what's the per capita rate of killing per person in this population. So I need to figure out what the populations of these two groups are. Well, black citizens account for 40 million people in the United States, whereas police officers or police law enforcement officers count for 635,000. So when I divide this number by this number, I get what's called the per capita rate of killing for that population. And it turns out that only black people kill other black people with a rate of 1 in 17,000, whereas law enforcement officers kill black people with a rate of 1 in 2,000. So it's much higher for law enforcement officers. Now, of course, I will say that I'm being slightly disingenuous here, because obviously law enforcement officers in the United States are routinely armed. Okay, so they're more likely to have a gun on them and to use it. Similarly, when you come across a law enforcement officer, it's likely to be in a situation where there's conflict. So it's possible that there's going to be aggravation and maybe a firearm is going to be drawn. But the point is not that these statistics hold any particular value in themselves, but that Liddle's argument that just because more black people are killed by other black people, it means that black people are the problem, is completely facetious. It's completely erroneous argument. Indeed, for white people, the same is true. These are the number of killings of white people in the United States. These are the number of killings of white people by law enforcement officers in the United States. Again, if you account for the absolutely massive size of the white population in the US, over 230 million, compared to the population of law enforcement officers, you see that white people kill other white people with a rate of 1 over 90,000, and law enforcement officers kill white people with a rate of 1 in 1,000. So exactly the same story holds true for white people as well.